You know, sometimes I feel like none of this is real. Like we're living in a movie or something.
What makes you say that?
It's like our actions are scripted. Like we're doing what's expected of us instead of acting rationally, even if it's something totally insane.
Well, Marty, maybe you're right. But we're the directors and the protagonists of that movie. At least I hope we are.
That's for sure. If we weren't, we'd be long dead.
Yeah, that's true.
Damn, we're late.
I don't see him anywhere.
But that jerk's here.
Yeah, the famous Scribbler Tim in the flesh. He must have seen something. And because he's here, he must have caught a whiff of a serious case. We should interrogate him.
Oh, let me be the bad cop, Boss Bird.
Permission granted.
Yes!
Just a minute.
Is that the Chitin Blues?
I think so. It has a unique sound to it, that's for sure.
I'd like to visit the Hive again, when things lighten up a little.
Yeah, and when they welcome cops again.
Yeah, right.
Might get a chance to soon, Marty.
Hey, old pal. Could you help us?
Does he understand us?
I don't know.
Excuse me. Have you seen where the raccoon went? The one who owns the joint? Nothing.
Maybe he's deaf or blind.
This sign summarizes the city's current attitude.
I think it's on most of them. There's
That's the cobbler district over there, or Cockroach Town.
Cockroach Town.
Or the Hive, as others call it. It was a nice, normal place when I moved to Clawville. Now it's an insect ghetto.
All right, Timothy.
Scribbler Tim.
Scribbler
Tim. Second-rate journalist and first-rate ass-kisser. He's a huge fan of the Chicken Police. Hey, Timbo.
Timbo.
My old pal.
Hey. Hello, boys. What a lovely welcome.
You're not scared to see us, are you?
Who? Me? What are you thinking? I'm always glad to see you working. Especially together like this is the legendary Chicken Police.
What the hell's going on here, Tim?
That's exactly what I was thinking. You see, what the hell could have happened here, right? Very strange, indeed.
Where's Zip, Timbo?
Keen observation, boys, because that's the most exciting thing about the story.
Let me guess. A ram and a bobcat appeared and took him with them.
Well, you could say that if it happened, but it didn't.
Then what?
Isn't it great? Here's the twist.
Start talking, Tim, or we'll have to see if you can really fly.
Come on, Sonny. I was supposed to be the bad cop.
Shut your beak, Marty.
Hey, quit playing tough, will ya? You know I'll help you even if you don't threaten me. I always do. Mostly.
Stop babbling. Just answer the question.
All right, Timber.
Have you seen anything weird around the river?
You mean the smoke and burning ship?
Exactly.
Oh, no. I haven't seen that.
What do you know about Madame Zavos, Timothy? What's the old hag up to these days?
I only know what everybody does. She's rich, she owns a brothel, allegedly she used to be a spy, and she's an enthusiastic supporter of the Crown and the Royalist Party.
What else?
Well, I haven't heard anything else, I swear. She's surrounded by secrets. She was a spy, you know.
Just
although...
Yes?
A little bird told me she's been entertaining quite a lot of foreign guests recently. I mean, real high-quality VIP guests.
Ooh. Who? From where?
Well, I don't know, but allegedly, she's welcomed patrons from Stavonia, Averia, and even Nautica. basically from everywhere that matters.
And?
Well, that's all. You know I can get into everywhere, but even I give the Nile a wide berth. Those wild girls are capable of anything protecting the madam. Trust me.
Yeah, we've noticed.
Yeah, kind of got that firsthand.
So, what about Zip?
I'm telling you, I don't know. He was already gone by the time I got here.
Why are you still sniffing around?
I was trying to make that fella talk over there.
What, the old fly guy? You speak insect?
What if I do? I'm educated, you know?
All right, Tim, my patience is gone. It's time you start singing like the songbird you are.
Hey, that's Seabird. Okay, okay, back off. We're old friends, aren't we?
Exactly. That's why I haven't smeared the walls with you yet.
Ouch.
You didn't say anything.
Hey, Timbo,
apart from
what about the old
thing?
Fly guy? Did he see something?
Maybe he did, but he's not talking. He didn't even speak when the coppers were asking him. And not even when one of them kicked him and the other spat on him. Tough fella indeed.
Those fuckers.
The fly was silent, no matter what. After they left, he just picked up his guitar and started strumming like nothing happened.
Poor bastard.
If I only knew who they were.
Then what? What'll you do? Beat them and spit on them? Like they did with this fella?
They deserve it.
Well, that's one thing, Marty, but things don't work that way.
Ooh, can interrogate him.
Timbo's a douchebag, so it's not hard to draw the truth from him.
Straightforward questions then, I guess. What are you doing? Why did you come
so
here?
So what the hell are you doing around here, Timbo?
All right, I confess, but you'll be surprised. I was looking for you, boys. The whole town's talking about you.
Really? I'm swelling with pride.
Everybody's whispering about the chicken police being back together again. And that you've already turned the whole city upside down.
Great news. What else do they say?
That you've threatened Ibn Wessler's sweetheart, Natasha, then trashed Madame Zavas's brothel. Hard stuff.
Really?
I think we did any of them, did we?
Oh, and the best! You set fire to a ship, too.
Yeah, right.
Ah, and one more thing. A poor girl was found dead at Natasha's place after you visited there.
Is that so? And you believe all that?
But I'm a journalist, Sonny. It doesn't matter what I believe.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, right. Well, I mean, if they think she's dead after we'd been there, how do they know we've been there? And we certainly didn't trash the brothel. I don't remember threatening Natasha. Maybe we did, I can't remember. And why were you looking for us here, of all places? Have you seen anyone else sniffing around? No, why were you here? Why were you looking for us here?
And why were you looking for us here, of all places?
You offend me, Sonny. I'm your biggest fan. I knew the hot dog's gonna be on your list.
So it was a lucky guess.
Something like that. And I'm wasting time here often anyway, so I had nothing to lose.
Is this not where
and
we met him before?
Here we are.
He went following us. No, he couldn't have been following us. He got here first. Out with it, Tim.
Out with it, Tim.
Who squawked?
Who squawked?
Well, any decent journalist has connections everywhere, Sonny. So have I.
So?
You don't think I'm gonna betray my source? What do you take me for, a rat? Sorry, I mean, I didn't mean it like that. I have no problem with rats.
What happened to Zip,
What though? Happened to Zip, Tim?
Okay. When I arrived here, the hot dog was already closed. Zip wanted to shoo me away, but I managed to persuade him to talk to me a little. We're old friends, Sonny, you know? And I have this personal charm.
Yeah, right. The charm. Get to the point, Timbo.
Okay. So, he was totally crazy. I've never seen him like that before. He was flustered, flailing, and talking absolute gibberish.
He must have said something, since you're such great friends.
He just said he'd go to the only place where there are even bigger scoundrels than those that are after him.
Really? I can guess what he meant.
I didn't have a clue. Anyway, after he closed the dog behind me, and then the cops came and took him away in handcuffs, I came to the conclusion that all of this makes no sense.
Zip, you clever son of a bitch.
Why? Ooh, what is it? Oh, tell me.
You just keep your beak out of this, Scribbler. I think I've got an idea about what our little friend's up to. Timbo loves to brag, and it's easy to approach him through his ego. Best if we ruthlessly exploit that.
Did Zip get taken away by the police on purpose so he could hide? Is that where he thinks the biggest scumbags are? Maybe. Juicy gossip, working on a new front page. You've got nothing better to do. Well, if we're playing to his ego, then he'd want a front page article, surely, as a reporter.
Working on a new front page article, eh?
Well, if a specific celebrity couple's willing to give me an interview, then maybe I am.
Don't even dream about it, Timby.
Oh, he thinks we're a couple. Who told you we were working together? As you also want to inform Tims to tell me about Madame Zyvas. How did you get rid of the cops? These two cops, who are they? We're still working with his ego.
As you're
so
well informed, Timster, tell me about Madame Zyvas.
Well, they say she's kinda angry because someone trashed her brothel. Oh, and that someone was allegedly you and Marty.
Yeah, you already told us. Good story. Anything else? With a little more truth in it.
Allegedly, Ibn Wessler's men were seen around the brothel. I have a hunch that they were the same two guys that came here, too.
Gee, that may even be true.
You pay attention to everything. Did anyone else come
Timbo,
here?
Timbo, you pay attention to everything. Did anyone else come here?
Besides the coppers? Yeah, a ram and a bobcat, in fact.
But you just told us it wasn't them.
Wasn't them what? I didn't say they took Zip, because that's not how it happened.
Don't make me mad, Tim. We're really not in the mood for this.
Hey, I'm only telling you the truth. They stopped here in a fancy big car, looked around, then left. Zip was no longer here. Neither were the coppers, okay?
Tiny Tim is a true fan of ours, and it's time to finally use that to our advantage.
This is important, Tim. Are you sure they were Wessler's goons? Help old pals, Tim. What was Zip doing before they took him away? Did you talk to Wessler's men? Did you pay attention, Timothy? How did Zip behave when they took him? Well, it seems saying he was me old mate, me old macker, me old pal.
Help your old pals, Tim. What was Zip doing before they took him away?
Hey, you're trying to grease me up with all that sweet talk, Sonny Honey.
Yep.
Of course not, Tim. We're old pals.
I'm sure we are, but I don't remember you telling me that without an ulterior motive. But you know what? I don't care. Feels good anyway.
I'm glad to hear that. So,
Zip was acting crazy. He was running around, knocking over everything, and throwing things away. Then he suddenly disappeared into the kitchen. I guess that's when he made the call, because soon after that, the coppers arrived.
And in between?
Well, I didn't see him in between.
Why didn't you go inside? He's your friend, isn't he?
Well, I tried, Sonny. The door was closed. I knocked, even yelled. You know how a yelling seagull sounds like, but nothing.
I think I have a hunch what that was all about.
Good for you, Sonny.
Zip was hiding something in the dog, right?
What do you mean exactly?
Trying to.
Well, you tell me. You're good old friends, aren't you?
Well, that's right, Sonny, but Zip's not the kind to easily share his secrets. But now that you put it that way...
That's more like it, Tim. Tell me, what do you know?
I don't know what it could be exactly. I mean, maybe it's not even relevant, but I'm sure Zip was trying to get rid of something when I arrived here.
What and where?
I don't know, okay? I already told you too much. If Zip hears about me telling you all this, he's never gonna talk to me again.
Tim, unless we find Zip, he's not gonna talk to anyone ever again. Not in this life, at least.
Yay! True detective. Not a legendary, but still pretty good. Zip is hiding something at the hot dog. We must find it before it's too late.
Are you looking for a headline even on New Year's Eve? Are you really that desperate?
Well, newspapers are,
I have to make a living somehow. So, tell me, how come you're working together again?
It's not work for us, Tim. It's just pure fun. Walk the city, get ourselves beat up, have a nice swim. And now, we happen to be here, of all places.
A nice cup of coffee feels especially good after a little thrashing, you know? You could experience that, too, in the near future.
If you can make good coffee, of course.
Well, plumy gods, take it easy, boys. I'll tell you what I know, just ask.
You already have. Let's go in here.
Look at this mess.
Looks like he was in a real hurry, or was trying to erase his tracks.
Because he was trying to hide something. But where?
And most of all, what?
Let's take a good look around.
Let me just... No, I'll check this later. Doodles. Oh, fuck the king.
Huh. What insight?
It's a bit worn down counter anyway. Where all the colours go?
Good question, pal. Ugh, I wouldn't dare touch that.
Can we make some hot coffee then? On the menu.
Ooh, maybe a peanut souffle with faux meat.
Oh, stop it, Marty, before I get sick.
Ugh, you're just a boring old man.
I'd rather be boring than dead.
Marty.
Greetings, pal. What can I get you?
What are you doing, Marty?
A nice hot cup of coffee?
Oh, yeah.
Maybe some toast? Ooh, our strawberry jam pancake is divine.
You must have hit your head pretty bad.
Yes, sir. One coffee and a turbo milkshake with extra vanilla and millet powder coming right up.
Ah, furry gods, help me. Please don't have a nervous breakdown, okay?
On Mavis.
When we get over this whole mess, I'm gonna take you to a concert.
No, you won't.
Yes, I will. Swear.
Yeah, well, good luck with that.
Oops, what's happened? Uh-oh. 1 minute. Oh, this is what Natasha sang? break me. Oh!
Look at this.
I'm looking, but what the hell could it be?
No idea, Marty. Guess it's best if we ask the owner himself.
Where do we find him?
Well, Timbo told us he's with even worse bastards than the one chasing him.
Police station.
That's it. The Parliament.
No, Marty, but close.
Then, no way.
Oh, yes, Marty. Zip is at the Clawville City Police Department.
Could it be that simple? And that wild?
Well, the cops took him. So it's obvious that he called the cops by himself to scare away Wessler's henchmen. Timbo was right.
Doesn't he know half the police is in Wessler's pocket?
He probably does, but this was his only chance.
Then he really is in big trouble. So? To the PD, then?
Well, I haven't got a better idea. Believe me, I'd love to have one.
All right, got a new clue. What is it? A wristband, but what the hell does it mean? 9842372. I'm guessing it's Natasha's. Hang on, am I? Yeah. Natasha's from her previous life. But was she a prisoner? Is that a prisoner wristband? She was somebody important, like the daughter of a king or a prince or something like that? Do they have kings and princes over there? I don't know. Oh, yeah. Jukebox on again. That one? That's the one. Oh, I wanted to play that one. What else have we got? Oh, it's in... Yeah, this is...
Why did you keep that wristband?
You kept it. It wasn't me.
Why did you keep...
Got blood on it. It looks... Is it like a doctor's hospital band? Oh well, how do we get back out?
Have you found what you were looking for?
No, Timbo, but we wouldn't tell you even if we did.
Ah, but you have. You are an open book to me, Sonny.
We didn't even know what was looking for anyway.
Thanks for the intel.
Be careful what you're writing, Timmy boy. I'm a cop for only the next 121 days. After that, I can gut you if I want, and get away with it.
And when did you being a cop stop you?
Yeah, that's a point.
That's true, yeah.
Just keep a low profile, okay, Timster?
Okay, I get it. My beak is sealed. Zoop!
Just wait until we're finished, then we can give you loads of dirt at that point.
If you want to know what happened, give me a good story in exchange.
I'll give you a story, all right. You'll be laying eggs from it, you cretin.
Oh, okay. Take it easy, Marty.
Yeah, take it easy, Big Bird. Jeez. I'll tell you what you want to know.
Well, can we ask him anything else? No. Wait, is that... Is there a reason why that's sort of more lightly crossed out?
Have you seen anything weird around...
You mean...
Exactly.
Oh!
No. All right. Well, I guess... Where are we going? To police station? Clawville PD? Been all of these places. All right, to the PD then.